The possibilities for additive manufacturing in production will be determined by the economics of additive manufacturing, and those economics are getting better. I recently spoke about this with Dan Kirsten of Additive Industries, who talked about additive manufacturing specifically as an alternative to casting. Talk about Additive Industries. Tell me about the aims of the company, the mission of the company.
So it's our mission as a company to lead metal additive manufacturing from prototyping into series production. So we've seen that the process has reached a point where indeed functional parts are possible, but the only thing that's hindering this technology to really move into series production was the fact that the equipment that was developed until now was developed with prototyping in mind rather than series production.
Why don't you talk a little bit about this piece that you brought?
I think this shows how you can scale small parts for large series. In a large build volume like ours, which is 420 by 420 millimeters and which can get to a height of 400 millimeters, you can really fit a lot of parts. And as you can see here, the numbers of parts allow you to do series production and still have a process that is batch-wise. I think what is key that people realize that the cost per part can be really low. So our target is to go after casting. And you can imagine casting prices are relatively competitive. There's a lot of casted products used in the automotive industry, for example. And we are convinced that by working together with the customer, we can get the metal additive manufacturing process to get closer and closer to casting. And if we're able to do that, then you can see an enormous growth of the number of parts that qualify for a positive business case for this technology.
An issue with casting is long lead times frequently. There is a need for tooling in casting. So a process such as this, by requiring no tooling, by being a much shorter lead time process, you could, I would imagine, launch a new product with a lower initial unit run of a new product launch because there is not as much lead time or tooling to justify at the outset. Does that sound right?
Yes, I think that's exactly the case. And especially in, for example, the automotive industry, you will see in the coming years that autonomous driving, electrification of the powertrain will bring new concepts to the market that have a lower volume than the traditional car manufacturers have today.
In your conversations with the automotive industry, do they have any particular concerns that are distinctive to their industry that come up when they contemplate additive technology for production?
I think what is key in the automotive industry is the combination of wanting the highest quality of parts combined with the lowest cost. And that is something we are continuously working with them to improve, the balance between the two. And I think this technology has a lot of potential in the future to do just that, to make that combination better. We already are better than casting when it comes to the quality of the parts and the integrity of the parts, as well as the predictability. And now we need to work on cost to also beat casting in that domain.
What would be involved in working on cost? What are the major cost factors right now that further innovation will be able to improve?
So if you look at the main components that make up the total cost, it is obviously the equipment that is used. And we are working continuously to increase productivity and with that reducing the cost that lands in a product. And then there's the material. So we work together with material suppliers to reduce the cost of the material. For example, with GKN, where we are experimenting with water atomized powders rather than gas atomized powders. Then labor. We were able to reduce labor in the cost per part from 20% to 2% by integration of process steps as well as automation. Mm-hmm. we were able to reduce labor. So today, the operator only has to load build plates in the machine and take out the ready parts, and needs to do maintenance, preventive maintenance, cleaning every now and then. So there we already are really, really close to eliminating labor altogether.